see, actually, you are interested in the Bauhaus.
What do you mean?
At first, I thought there was only one place in your work where you refer to it, in A Thousand Plateaus, when you quote from a lecture by Paul Klee. We seek a people, we begin over there in the Bauhaus. More we cannot do.
Oh, but that hardly has anything to do with the Bauhaus. When Klee spoke about the people he was seeking, he just happened to be one of the teachers of this art school.
He taught there for a total of almost 10 years, and it is precisely during this time that he made the statement you quote in A Thousand Plateaus. In addition, one of the clay paintings that fascinated Félix Guattari and you was also created during this period, the twittering machine.
Oh, we've already talked about the twittering machine. Overall, however, the Bauhaus stands for a completely different direction, a completely different tradition than Félix and me. First, when we began our collaboration, the Bauhaus had long ceased to exist. Second, we wanted to develop a new theory of society and subjectivity, whereas the Bauhaus aimed at a new practice of design and architecture. And third, we stand for a complex thinking of the unconscious and its multiple connections, while the Bauhaus represents the reduction of modernism, the rational and the functional, form follows function, etc., and so on and so forth.
But these are just Bauhaus clichés. What you describe may apply to the middle and the late Bauhaus in Dessau, but not to the early expressionist and wild Bauhaus in Weimar, where Klee started to work.
I was actually quite fascinated by Klee's pictures, but also by his texts, his idea of chaos as a tangled bundle of apparent lines. The idea that creativity in this bundle starts from a gray point and establishes via rhythm its own order, its own milieu. We have talked about chaos and rhythm the other day, if you recall.
Right, when it came to synesthesia and the body without organs. As far as rhythm is concerned, I would like to remind you of something else. There's an anecdote about Klee. When he began working at the Weimar Bauhaus in 1921, a rhythmic stomping could sometimes be heard from coming from his studio. When asked about the strange noise, he replied, "I was painting away. When all of a sudden, it was stronger than I began to dance. I otherwise never dance."
Oh, what a wonderful story about synesthesia. The dancing painter. Sounds somehow familiar to me, though.
Your friend Lyotard quotes this anecdote in his book Discourse Figure.
Ah, that's right. Now that you mention it, I remember. Lyotard's book was very important for Félix and me because right at the beginning of our collaboration, it opened up a way to think the unconscious far from language. That is, independently of the signifiers in Lacan's sense. It is precisely in this vein that we quote Lyotard's book in Anti-Oedipus.
Even in your last joint work, one finds traces of the Bauhaus. Not only that you return to the question of minorities and the revolutionary subject, that is, the idea of the missing people, On the last pages of What is Philosophy, by the same token, you mention the aesthetics of Kandinsky, who also taught at the Bauhaus.
You're right. In What is Philosophy, we also write stuff like, and I quote, art begins not with flesh, but with the house. That is why architecture is the first of the arts. End of quote. We even refer to Henry van der Velde, the great Bauhaus pioneer, because he, just like Jean Dubuffet later, located the brute or raw state of art in the open relationship between architecture, sculpture, and painting. According to this view, a house is nothing other than a fundamental framing, a delimitation of a territory, even if through simple rhythms.
You see, there are a lot of points of contact between your philosophy and the Bauhaus.
Yes, that is how it seems. But I really can't tell you why that is. Maybe Felix knows the answer. He has always been interested in architecture and in bodily movements through space, in rhythms and refrains. I have a meeting with him soon and can ask him then.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thanks. And say hi to Felix.